Hello, everybody. My name is Jody Jeans, and I am from Ibby's Restaurant. And I would like to talk to you about how to make a meal simple and fast for your family with any dietary restrictions. The premise of the show is to be able to come home after work, put something together in 30 minutes, and make it delicious, even if somebody is keto-friendly or afagal or gluten-free. I will show you ways to do each individual dish in a timely fashion and have a wonderful dinner with your family without any cleanup that's longer than 5 minutes. So today we are going to cook fresh Chilean sea bass. Since we had some at the restaurant, I figured I'd use that rather than salmon. We're going to do a kind of a take on a green bean almondine and roasted red potatoes. Now, if you don't want to do roasted red potatoes, you can do roasted vegetables of any kind, whether it's green peppers, red peppers, yellow, some onions, zucchini, squash, and it will cook in the same amount of time as the red peppers and the fish. So I'm going to start from scratch. Basically, this is what you do when you get home. All I've done is lay the ingredients out. I will put out in the menu that is attached to the show how much of everything that you're to use. But as far as cooking on the fly, I don't really measure a lot. So you can barely mess it up. As long as you don't put too much salt in it or too much spicy stuff, you can always recover. So first thing we're gonna do is a little shortcut to making sure the cleanup is snappity snap. So I always line my pans with foil. Make sure you get around the edges, you know, leave a little on the sides in case you need to fold it over if something is getting too brown. And then do the whole foil on the second sheet. And I'm only cooking for two tonight because that's the only people that are coming home. So I'm going to do it to where I can have this pan. And then I'm going to put this pan inside. And since they cook about the same time, I'm going to start on this side of the pan with the potatoes because they are going to take just a little bit longer. So get your mister out with your olive oil, spray it really good. You can use olive oil spray with Pam. I just prefer to use this, less chemicals, stuff like that. Not that I am against using the Pam, because trust me, in a pinch, I'll use anything. So next we're going to start with the potatoes, and I just got these little red ones. They're delicious. You know, if you want to cut them into, the only thing you should do is cut them the same size. That way, they'll all cook at the same time. I usually quarter them like that. And unless they're, you know, too large or something, you might have to do it in sixes. And then you're going to do your little trusty bag trick that we're going to go over. You know, chop up however many you think, you know, you and your significant other or children or whoever you're going to eat. Like that one's a little bit larger. So I'm going to cut it down just a tad. And then I'm going to go. And this one's a little bit larger. Just remember, some of them will not be done if you don't try to cut them the same size. You're looking for about like that. You know, something not very hard to do. So now, and if you have children that like to help you out, now is a good time to get them to help you. You can get a little knife, teach them how to start working in the kitchen, you know, give you a hand. That way they can get the potatoes in faster. You can prepare the stuff in the bag. Everything, that's probably enough for two. So now we're going to go in with I like the Zesty Italian. You can use anything. You can put together your own mix. It really doesn't matter. Just something with seasoning, and you know, just to make them tasty. I'm going to use for this amount probably half of this bag at the most. You know, and save this for something else. You can put it on cauliflower or anything. Go in with olive oil. Make sure you have enough to coat the potatoes. That is the main thing. Any leftover will stay in the pan because we're going to get them off with the spatula. Put them in the bag. Now give them a really good shake because you have a lot of seasonings in there going a lot of different directions. And at this point, if you want to spice it up a little bit, put some red pepper flakes in there. I'm a big fan of those. Also, you can put onions with this, however you want to do it. Take your bag, use it to spread everything out. Try not to let them touch. That way they'll get nice and crispy and delicious, like that. This is part of the reason why you're going to make sure that you have enough spray in the pan. Go ahead and put these in the oven. And they're in 10 minutes, which is what it should take us to get together the rest of the fish and the preparation on the green bean / kind of almondine thing that we're going to cook. So far we've spent about 5 minutes on this. And it took me like 2 minutes to get everything out. Not a lot of time. Everything, is going together perfectly. And we're going to take our sea bass. Now, these are Chilean sea bass fresh. Internal temperature, you're going to want to do 145. Sea bass is not a fish that you can overcook as easily as some of them because of the buttery flavor and the texture. It's going to actually flake apart. It's delicious. Even if you don't like fish, you will like this fish. Make sure you get the pan sprayed really good. I can't stress that enough. And the cleanup, and also this sea bass is very tender, so you definitely do not want it sticking to the pan. For the sea bass itself, we're going to use a lighter seasoning than you would on some fish because sea bass has a distinct flavor. Like I said, the butteriness, it's quite delicious. Of course, my spray thing's malfunctioning. But, you always have a backup of the pan. Get that really good. And over here, I have a mixture of... I'm going to do this keto-friendly because I already have potatoes. So I'm going to put a little bit of almond flour. And not many people can tell the difference in an almond flour when they are putting it on fish and breading it in the oven. And I'll tell you why. I think the almond it gets buttery when it cooks. And it's almost better than a breadcrumb because it doesn't burn as easily. And the flavors come out much, much easier as far as almond flavor. I've got a little bit of lemon pepper in here, some garlic salt, garlic powder. We're going to put some fresh cracked pepper. And as you can tell, it's not really, it's not really measured out. It's kind of measured out. But like I said, you don't want to overthink this. Don't sit there and use measuring tools to measure out a little teaspoon of salt or, this is more garlic than they said use. Don't make it hard on yourself. A lot of times when customers call me up, they're like, Jody, I have to cook for 4 people and I don't really know what to do and what if I mess it up? And I'm like, look, just take it easy. You should see us back in the kitchen at the restaurant because when we're at Ippy's, when they say add salt to it, it's salt. And if it's over salty, you have to start over. But you don't have time to sit back there with little measuring spoons and measure everything, and I would never want you to. That's why I don't bake, because I don't have the attention span for that, short of having somebody measure it all out for me, and then I'll need a sous chef, and then what's going to happen from there? So back to the fish. We are going to put some of this on the top of both of these. And make sure you don't want to kill it with it, but you want to, get almost all the sides, give it a little pat like that. Don't do it too heavy because you don't want it to taste milly or anything like that. And then since my squirter's not working properly, I'm going to break out the trusty, always have a backup plan. That's my motto. Go there and give it a good squirt of the olive oil. And then just let it sit there just for a second because you want the oil to absorb in the almond flour. And then that way it'll help stick to it a little bit better when you flip it over and put it in the pan. Go try to get the sides too with, whatever's left, just so you want everything to taste good. And then we're going to go straight to the pan. We're not going to put it back on the paper towel. Another thing you want to worry about is this piece of fish is just a little bit thicker than this piece. And a little trick that we do at the restaurant sometimes is we're going to cut this just a little bit and push it down a tad, because you want them to cook evenly. And, you know, I wouldn't do this with salmon or anything, but trust me, with the sea bass, you don't want to overcook it. And I'm going to squish this one up just a little bit, just to make it so it's even. So then we're going to go back in and put this on both of these. Pretty good. You know, nothing scary-like. But just make sure you get it all, get the sides, get back here. Now, at this time, like I said before, if you want to put anything spicy, anything like that, oregano, whatever, you can do it. But remember, sea bass is a very mild fish. You do not want to overpower the natural flavor of the fish. You just want to let it do its thing, and you know, it's just going to be beautiful. Everybody loves this fish. And if you don't love the fish, if you try this recipe, you will like this fish. So we're going to spray those up really good. And then a little trick that I learned a long time ago is you take a little butter, very thin little pieces, and you put it one right here, and then one beside it on each one. That way you don't have all like tons of butter in here. Some people, you know, especially if you're cooking in a high heat oven and then you're in a restaurant setting, you're gonna of course dump all that butter off. But here in your home, I mean, you don't want to have to deal with all that. It's all about easy to prepare, easy to serve, easy cleanup. We want you to be able to cook at home when you're not eating at Ippy's and I'm cooking for you there. We want to make it easy for you and healthy for whatever diet that you have. So now we're going to take these and we're going to put it in the oven, and it is on 450 degrees. The potatoes have been in there now for almost 15 minutes. So this is going to take probably 12 minutes to cook, and then everything will come out together. So always check your potatoes, and we're gonna rotate these because they're cooking pretty good. But just bring them out, give them a little, you know, let's see, the pan's leaning and you don't want them to stick. We're gonna give them just a little turnaround. Maybe do a fork test on them, because you know we're actually cooking live here, just to see where they are. Yeah, they're going to be perfect because it's going in there, but not completely, you know, piercing it as it would be done. So there you go. We're going to put this, set this on top of here. Make sure, don't squish them, you know, let them be a little bit separate like I'm not doing. So we're going to separate these to where they can get a little crispy and not touch each other. And then we're gonna go back into the oven with this. And we're gonna set a timer for 15 minutes is where I would do the first check to make sure that the fish is done, the potatoes are done. And if the fish is done and the potatoes are not done, the fish can definitely come out and sit just for a second. It's not going to hurt anything. And if the potatoes need more time, put them in there. If you want your potatoes crispy, turn them on broil. And if you want cheese on your potatoes at that point in time, that is when you would add that. So when we come back, we are going to do my take on a green bean almondine. And then we're going to plate up this delicious meal and give it a little test. So come back in just a few minutes. Thank you so much.
Are you looking for great food and entertainment? Ippy's Restaurant is the place to be. We have been serving local communities since 1919. With made-from-scratch entrees and specialty dishes like our famous Oyster Rockefeller, smoked prime rib, and hand-carved filet mignon, we have a great selection of menu items that are all made to order for your everyday dining or special occasions. We also offer private rooms, catering services, and have a wonderful assortment of local bands that play in the lounge. Ippy's Restaurant and Lounge, 1760 North Main Street, Rocky Mountain.
Everyone's doing it. Follow your neighborhood network on social media. See news live as it happens. See more local content. Your neighborhood network proudly serving Martinsville and Henry County. Jody's Kitchen is brought to you in part by the Harvester Performance Center. World-class entertainment year-round. Harvester Performance Center, downtown Rocky Mount. Visit harvester-music.com.
Everything we have is right here in town. If we don't have it at this location, we have several of the stores that we are definitely in communication with, of which, you know, myself or anyone would be happy to drive no matter the distance to get what exactly you're looking for, whether it be a color or a case or a phone. Well, the great thing about us is we're current members of the Chamber of Commerce. A lot of our employees are local. We've been here, we're from here, been here 7 years and established a great relationship with the community. So we look forward to serving the community and actually have being an impact in the community. You know, people come over every day. They want to stop in to Kroger and pick up a few things, or right next door to our one main financial location, you know, or even Suntan City, people who come over for their everyday needs. You know, so it's definitely a high volume, just for convenience alone. You know, you pop over to Kroger and get gas, or you're going to stop by, you know, your local restaurant down the street and get a bite to eat. You know, we're right there within arm's reach of it all.
Are you looking for great food and entertainment? Ippy's Restaurant is the place to be. We have been serving local communities since 1919. With made-from-scratch entrees and specialty dishes like our famous Oyster Rockefeller, smoked prime rib, and hand-carved filet mignon, we have a great selection of menu items that are all made to order for your everyday dining or special occasions. We also offer private rooms, catering services, and have a wonderful assortment of local bands that play in the lounge. Ippy's Restaurant and Lounge, 1760 North Main Street, Rocky Mountain.
You've got it all at your fingertips. Video, email, music, and now BTW 21, your neighborhood network. The all-new BTW21.com. Local news at your fingertips.
Welcome back. So far today, we have put the sea bass in the oven with the roasted potatoes. It's been in there for 30 minutes. It's just about done, and so now we are going to finish up this delicious meal with my take on a green bean almondine kind of thing. So first of all, we're going to put the stove on a medium heat and let it get pretty hot. We're going to take one clove of garlic. And I always smash that out really nicely and get it kind of a fine chop. You know, it doesn't have to be too small. You just want it to be, you know, small enough to where when you take a nice bite of it, it's not gonna be too strong in your mouth. And if you want more garlic, like I said, this is what options. You don't have to stick to everything. Too much garlic would probably be 3 or 4 for what we're making. You don't want to go overboard too much. All right, so then we're going to put a little bit of red onion. And it can be as fine as you want it or not. All right, now we're going to put this in the pan with some olive oil because it's hot now. This is an induction oven, so it's really fast, and if you've never heard of that, I highly suggest that. Those are probably the best thing that I ever invested in when I redid my kitchen. Yeah, I used to cook in this kitchen and it was this big. Everything was very, very small. So this has definitely been a dream of mine to help people out. You know, people calling into the restaurant, like I said, with a crisis mode, you know, what do I do now? Or I have people coming over and I didn't know they were coming. All these things are easy. I mean, easy steps to do and take care of dinner really fast. All right, so you may use fresh beans. But like I said, we are doing this to where we're coming home from work. Always keep things in your freezer. Always keep green beans, corn, chicken tenders. I mean, you could fix chicken tender, green beans, and corn in no time. And it just is simple, fast, delicious. You don't have to buy prepackaged things that have all kinds of stuff in there. You don't know what it is. All right, let this saute just for a minute. You don't want to burn the garlic, that's for sure. And then start putting in your almonds. I kind of like a few more almonds than most because I'm doing the keto. And, you know, everybody loves green bean almondine. Let that cook just for about 2 minutes. And then I splurge on the Parmesan cheese. This is the Reggiano, and it lasts forever. You can't go wrong with it. It's got a buttery quality. You know, you just put it on at the end. I'll let y'all see how it's kind of like really hard, and it's got the label on the outside, which is, you want to look for that just to make sure that you're getting the right thing. So we're gonna do quite a bit of this because we're gonna put it on top of the almonds and stuff. I'll go over here and stir. Make sure you want to get them on both sides. A little toasty, but not too bad. And I've already taken the beans and put them in the microwave just to speed it up a little and get it ready faster. You can do that if you want to or not. A little stir. Now, on the seasonings, we're going to go simple. We already have garlic in there. I'm going to put a little bit of Italian seasoning, probably like a teaspoon because I measure so well, and a little bit of fresh ground pepper. Let that cook just for a couple minutes. All nice and hot, toasty. Like I said, while the fish was cooking, I had plenty of time to straighten up the kitchen. This is like actual real time that we're working on. You saw when I started, we were exactly just things out on the table. That's it. And we're gonna give that one more little slice. That should be plenty. I always just store this in here so I can pull it right out. It's ready to go. Let's check on the fish and see how it is doing now. See if it is ready. You can smell that. I wish you could smell this garlic. And the almonds and the olive oil. It smells delicious. Oh yeah. Look at how beautiful that is. Potatoes are nice and toasty. The fish is perfectly cooked, we hope. We're gonna go in here with our instant read thermometer. $10 everywhere. Oh, definitely. I'm cooking these to about 155, 160, just because I like the texture a little bit better like that. You don't have to do that. You only have to cook it to 145. Sea bass is a very buttery fish, so if you cook it a little bit more, it'll give it just a teeny bit more texture. And I think it makes it taste good, but you know, it's all about preference. You don't have to do everything the way the recipe says, or you don't have to do everything the way I'm telling you to do it. So we're gonna let that sit there just for a second. And always taste your food as you're cooking. Because like I said, these are beans and I put them in there and we don't know if it's right. Needs a little bit more salt. So we're gonna go in with Just a touch of garlic salt. Give it a spin, maybe just a little bit more pepper. And we are gonna finish this up with a nice chunk of butter, because you know, that always makes it better. Give that a stir. And while that is incorporating and melting down, we are going to plate up the potatoes and the fish. Excuse me. Now this right here is gonna, see how flaky and tender that is? It is just delicious. Of course, it is the king of the sea, I think. Nice piece on there. Scoot your taters this way. Look how golden brown they are and crispy. I mean, all we did was put it in the oven. Put it in a Ziploc, put some seasoning on it. Very, very simple. There you go. And then we're gonna, the beans are just done. Yummy. Put that on there. Let me get this out of the way. Now we are gonna top this with the Parmesan all over the beans. You can put it on the potatoes if you want. I'm just gonna do the beans. And we are going to give it one taste on the sea bass. See what you think. Look at how juicy that is. Mmm. Delicious. Delicious. The potatoes are crispy. Perfectly cooked. I'll tell you, to make something easy, the cleanup, basically put the foil in the trash, finish out the pans, one pan, and then you're good to go. And like I said, you saw exactly what I did from start to finish. I'm gonna just keep coming back at y'all with new recipes, easier way to cook things. You know, some of them might be a little bit more time consuming than others, but it will always be easy and affordable and hopefully delicious. So thank you so much for tuning in at Jody Jean's Kitchen. And when you're not cooking at home, think about coming out to see us at Ippy's Restaurant. Have a good day.
Jody's Kitchen is brought to you in part by the Harvester Performance Center. World-class entertainment year-round. Harvester Performance Center, downtown Rocky Mount. Visit harvester-music.com.
Everything we have is right here in town. If we don't have it at this location, we have several of the stores that we are definitely in communication with, of which, you know, myself or anyone would be happy to drive no matter the distance to get what exactly you're looking for, whether it be a color or a case or a phone. Well, the great thing about us is we're current members of the Chamber of Commerce. A lot of our employees are local. We've been here, we're from here, been here 7 years and established a great relationship with the community. So we look forward to serving the community and actually have being an impact in the community. You know, people come over every day. They want to stop in to Kroger and pick up a few things, or right next door to our one main financial location, you know, or even Suntan City, people who come over for their everyday needs. You know, so it's definitely a high volume just for convenience alone. You know, you pop over to Kroger and get gas, or you're going to stop by, you know, your local restaurant down the street and get a bite to eat. You know, we're right there within arm's reach of it all.